Today's question is, what's a bot? A lot of people have been talking about bots in the accounting profession as we move from manual to digital to everything automated. Bots are becoming an important part of how we increase our efficiency. So the question is, what's a bot? Well, we got good bots and we have bad bots. But really, a bot is a software application that is programmed to do certain tasks. Bots are automated, which means they run according to their instructions without a human user needing to start them up. Bots often imitate or replace a human user's behavior. Bots do repetitive tasks well. You set up the structure and they can do them much faster than human could. Let's take a couple of examples of what a bot can do. Let's take, for instance, you receive an email that contains an invoice. If you were a human, you would take it out of the envelope, you would look at it, and then you would enter the data into an accounting or bookkeeping system. Bots, which are automated, can extract the data and then type that information into an accounting or bookkeeping system. We see that with QuickBooks and Xero and NetSuite. They're applications that automatically take the information when an email comes in and puts it into the accounting system. So bots save us time. They take over repetitive tasks that employees carry out 50, 60 times a day and automate the function, make it easier for us to do things. And again, saves us time. This slide shows a number of examples of what I'll call RPA in action, robotic process automation. We've set up the bots to process automatically different things, like taking periodic reporting data entry and putting it into information so we can do data analysis. Mass email extractions, archiving and extracting. Again, everything is here to save us time. So as we look towards the future of accounting, the future of accounting is letting the lower value services be done via automation and bots, and us as accountants doing the high level work, which is advisory services to our clients. Because even though clients say they come to the accountant to get their tax return done, their payroll tax, sales tax, bank recs, financial statements, they really come to us as the experts to help them be more liquid, solvent, and profitable. They want us to help them be better in running their business. They know what their business is about. They don't want to be working in the business. They want to be working on the business. Through our advisory services, we can help them. And through our utilization of automation and bots, because I truly believe we're going to take more and more of what we do from the journal entry to the posting to the ledger, to the trial balance, to the worksheet, to real-time accounting information. We're going to let automation take that so that we can help our clients with other things. Right now, we use a lot of apps in relationship to helping our clients perform their tasks. But bots, which are similar to apps, but maybe can do a lot more because they are learning a lot more, make it easier. A good example, I use an app to turn on the lights in the house. I went from that to now I have a bot, Alexa. When I walk in the house, they say, Alexa, please turn on the lights. So that's an example of replacing an app with a bot. But I think bots are in our future. And as we move future forward, it's all about automation and artificial intelligence. AI is the science of training machines to perform human tasks. AI holds a concept that a computer can act like a human brain, calculating the road around us every second of every day. Sounds like I'm driving a self-driving automobile. Artificial intelligence includes reasoning, cognitive processing, natural language recognition, planning and other research fields, in addition to machine learning, because we can't have artificial intelligence, in my opinion, without machine learning, because machine learning is the field of science that explores the development of algorithms that can learn from and make predictions on data. The main difference with other common algorithms is the learning piece. Machine learning algorithms are not a series of processes serially executed to produce a desired result. They are instead a series of processes aiming to learn patterns from past events and build functions that can produce good predictions with a degree of confidence. I see that as an example in the accounts payable field, where machine learning has come into play and artificial intelligence to make it easier for paying bills. So as we move forward, to me, it's all about automation. We let bots perform a variety of the repetitive finance tasks. Again, as I said, when I think of accounts payable process from manually to automated, I actually think of a company called VicAI, which makes it easier and reduces the amount of time it takes you to process your payables. So what does it get us if we let bots take over and we automate the process? It allows us to work more accurately. Bots always follow the rules and don't make any errors. Automation will significantly reduce the error margin. We'll gain productivity. Software robots perform time-consuming, repetitive tasks rapidly. And one thing, we don't pay them overtime, they're available 24/7. We'll be able to boost compliance. Every task that a bot performs is traceable, which means we have an audit trail if we have to look back. We automate, we can cut costs, we can improve productivity, and the few errors will help us lower our costs. Moreover, the ROI on RPA is fast. As we write the routine, or you bring somebody else in. I'm not an expert on writing the routines. I know what I want done. So I have associates that are experts in data analytics and in computer programming. I tell them what needs to be done, and they write the API to perform the robotic process automation over and over again. And with this, we'll gain an edge. By automating a process, we can reassign personnel. I don't have to do the task. I don't have to delegate them to someone in my firm to enter data and sort through information. The bot's doing it. And then we can spend more time dealing with our clients, advising them, and building better relationships. So to me, the future is all about utilizing all the different levels of automation. And when I think about all the transitions and technological revolutions we've had in accounting, you know, and it started with the quill. I always like to use Bob Cratchit as my example, working on the books, to a contaminator, to an adding machine, to a computer, to a bot, to artificial intelligence. You know, think about Excel and what Excel did to working with spreadsheets. Today, bots are increasingly gaining a foothold in the accounting profession. In the coming years, the level of intelligence is expected to rise dramatically. RPA, or robotic process automation, leverages the computing power of software to automate high volume, error-prone, repeatable tasks. At this stage, software bots mimic human activity. They are not intelligent on their own. Machine learning involves a first level of computer intelligence. Bots manage to make predictions based on patterns and correlations in large amounts of data. Cognitive computing systems try to simulate human thought with the aim of making high-level decisions in complex situations. And then we have artificial intelligence. Systems add real intelligence to machines. The bots learn the variables they should pay attention to from humans to then take decisions, make decisions, and give orders on their own. How far they go? That's the futuristic end of it. And when we look at these trends that I'm talking about, and we look at what's a bot, and we understand that bots are really automating functions, taking advantage of the machine learning, and the producing more desired results as the machine gets smarter, artificial intelligence allows the bot to make decisions based on the information that's been gathered. We look at the trends that CPA.com puts out every year. CPA.com is the marketing arm of the AICPA. This was their mega trends for 2020. And it sort of goes with what I'm talking about with what's a bot, because there's a lot of stuff or a lot of information in here that relate to bots. Smart robots, augmented intelligence, conversational AI, machine learning, RPA. And everything that we talk about seems to be, let's put it in the cloud because the cloud connects everything and we have the Internet of Things moving up and down the channel. I hope I've answered the question of what's a bot and why it's needed. If you have any further questions, feel free to reach out. We're here to help. Dave Bergstein's the name. It's all about accounting and automation is what I'm looking for.